That was Gogglebox, which you can catch on Channel 4 Thursday at 10. I went onto that by mistake this week. It's people sitting watching television and saying what they think of the shows. But it's just brilliant sitting in people's houses. And what you don't realise is when people watch TV, what you do realise, is all people do is talk to each other all the way through it.
So
all look at him, do you want a slice of pizza and all the stuff like that? It was great, really good show. OK, Jinky Poo's time now.
Hello.
With Rebecca, how are you?
I'm good, thanks. How are you?
I'm very good, thank you. And today we're doing rosé.
Yes, got some lovely rosés for
I'm
you.
I'm not a fan of rosé, so I'm intrigued by that.
I love a rosé. Emma, do you
like
a rosé?
I was drinking rosé last night with Alan Deck, actually, and I felt a bit tipsy after a couple.
Was that during the show?
During and after.
You had a refit there for screen in front of Deck.
Ant and Deck
drink rosé.
Do the show drunk, is that what you're
no,
saying?
No, they didn't drink during, I
That's
did.
What I heard.
I heard that's what I
heard.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So rosé for me is too sweet.
Okay, well, I've got some dry ones for you.
Oh, okay.
So, things are looking up already.
Because what people do is they get rosé in the summer and then they put ice in it.
Yeah, which isn't the best
which takes the flavour away.
Yeah, it can sort of dilute the flavour and make it too cold as well, because a wine that's too cold, you won't get the most of the flavour.
Don't get the flavours, do you?
Exactly, yeah.
So
this is lovely.
Cheers.
And cheers to, who's this?
Simon in Wakefield.
Simon in Wakefield.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, good tankard.
So this is a Provençal rosé from Provence, obviously, in France, and it's dry. It's got lots of sort of strawberry, red fruits. It's made by an English guy called Stephen Cronk. Went out there, a bit of a success story.
Ooh.
I really like it. What do you think?
I think it's a dependable rosé.
Yes,
it's kind of everything you expect from one. Mm. You won't like that. You'll think it's too sweet, too fruity.
Yeah, it's too fruity.
It is quite sweet,
it's
actually.
Right. Yeah. It's quite fruity.
Like
you say that's dry.
But the finish is dry, isn't it?
Yeah, and it's got a lovely sort of acidity towards the end. I think it's great. It's the kind of thing makes me feel like I'm on a terrace in France with a glass of
wine. Hold on, let me have a little thing.
Yeah, that's better, okay.
I feel like I'm just sitting in Stanley Park. By the swings.
Definitely nicer when you picture your... Yeah.
Which way are you looking, towards Goodison or towards Anfield?
Towards Goodison, the People's Club, Simon.
Do you taste a little bit bitter?
Let's stop doing football chat.
It was a joke. Okay. I think that's a decent, dependable rosé. Yeah, but it hasn't excited me.
Okay, well, let's try the next one. Now, this one is from Cornwall. Okay. So this is a bit different.
Cheers.
And cheers to Sarah and Stuart from Lancy in West
Sussex. Cheers. Oh, it's romantic, isn't it?
So this is from Cornwall. This is 100% Pinot Noir. It's made by a very successful winemaker, Campbell Valley.
That's nice, isn't it? It's lighter, I think.
It's really, really super wine. It wins lots of awards. Brilliant winemaker, Bob Lindo, his name is.
Is that expensive?
£11.95, so
because
not going to break
the thing about English wines, I sometimes think that, you know, unfortunately, they have to be expensive.
Yeah, because of yields and so on, like the amount that you can actually make is lower. But no, this one is great value, I think, and it's a really good food wine, great with like barbecued fish and grilled meats, things like that. You could, you know, really mix it up, have it with whatever. Barbecue wine, actually, should we ever get us summer.
Yes. I like this one.
I think it's a quaffable one, that, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, very easily.
Do you like that one? Yeah.
Yes, I like this one. This is my favourite so far.
And,
so, one is Californian.
Is rosé something you drink?
Yes, I do, actually, definitely, especially in the summer. Cheers. Spring, summer, yeah.
And cheers to Holly.
Cheers,
Holly.
Cheers, Holly.
Cheers, Tim. Cheers, Simon.
Holly needs a drink.
She does need a drink.
She likes
So what's good about this one? What's this one?
So this is Californian.
Is my favourite.
So Californian wine, this is called Ménage à Trois. It's got three grapes in it. It's got Gewürztraminer in it, which is a very fragrant white grape, very, very floral. So this has a more... Yeah, this isn't necessarily going to be to your taste.
I don't like that. That's my favourite one.
It's nice, isn't it? It's got lots of sort of strawberry, kind of bit of tropical fruit going on, lovely floral fragrances.
Very fruity.
It's super fruity.
I've got to be honest, I sometimes find that California roses taste like wine made for people who don't like wine. Do you know what I mean? You know, do you know what I mean?
He just insulted you.
Yeah. He did, didn't he? Completely.
Yeah, but you know, as an overall, you know what I mean? That it tastes like, if you, it just, because it doesn't taste
of
wine.
It's got something a bit different in there. It's a bit flowery.
Yeah, you know, I just think it's too kind of, it tastes
I
like
I don't know anything
juice.
About wine, really. So, well,
just
it's like
just fruit
it.
Juice.
Californian, particularly Californian rosé, yeah. Not this one, but they have they had a bit of a bad reputation. Like, they were made about 20 years ago. Winemaker had what's called a stuck fermentation, where you can't carry on making wine out of something, and that turned into made that blush wine.
That's not a million miles off of fruit juice.
Yeah. No, it's not.
Right. It's like an elderflower.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah, like fruit juice. Right.
Pick your favourite. I'm going middle.
I'm
middle.
Going second one.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
We're all going middle.
Fine.
Middle.
Going unanimous. Second. Yeah, brilliant. Thank you. Brilliant. Thank you.
Fantastic.
Okay.
Thank you.
After the break, Tim and I are making the elegant yet simple dish, chicken and mushroom roulade.
And don't forget to keep sending in your kitchen pictures. Here's Rebecca's, apparently. This is Rebecca's kitchen. Is it? Oh!
Oh! Ooh. Hello!
I write
a bit of entertaining.
No, I do. I write cookbooks in there as well.
Are the bids staying or going? Find out later in the show. See you after the break.
Get them off.